Main Street is the lifeblood of a rural community. That's where you'll find a place to get a cup of coffee, a grocery store, the post office, and drugstore. In some small towns where a doctor or nurse, hospital, clinic may be miles away, the pharmacist is the only healthcare professional in town.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Welcome to the morning huddle.
Bobbi Freitag is a staff pharmacist at Lakeview Medical Center and a relief pharmacist at Marshfield Clinic in Rice Lake, a community of 8,500 in northwest Wisconsin.
I grew up in Thorpe. My parents are actually from the Rice Lake and Turtle Lake area. And I had an uncle that was a pharmacist up in Duluth, Minnesota. And I liked chemistry. I knew I didn't want to be a doctor or a nurse. But to be honest, it never really occurred to me to stay in the bigger city. I knew there was lots of opportunities and lots of need.
If you are a rural health pharmacist, you're a jack of all trades, meaning that you're that person that patients are going to go to and ask any health-related question.
Any questions for you?
No, not at this time.
Okay.
We tend to be generalists. A lot of different hats. You're the administrator, so you're handling the contracts and the purchasing. You're also doing the clinical part, the distribution, and that's physically getting the medication into the pharmacy and then from the pharmacy to the nurse to give to the patient. And there's the education piece, whether we're teaching about warfarin, whether we're teaching about the new generic biosimilar drugs that are coming out. A lot of times it's supporting, again, behind the scenes.
There's been a huge expansion in the role of pharmacists. Pharmacies are not just the places where patients go and have medications dispensed in rural areas. Pharmacists are actually providing medication information. They play a big role in providing vaccinations. They're providing medication therapy management to keep patients healthier, keep them out of the hospitals. And they're also very complementary to other healthcare providers in rural areas.
The expanded role of a rural pharmacist and the appeal of a small town lifestyle are the reasons why Mike Laird chose to enter the profession.
When I was a student at Madison, I had the opportunity to do some rotations actually at Rice Lake. And at that time, the hospital was right on the lake, and I was sitting in the director's office, staring out over the lake, watching the eagle flying over. Basically, I'm living where people want a vacation. So that's a big part of why I want to be in rural healthcare. You know every doctor here. I know every nurse here. I had the same doctor deliver all three of our children. And that sort of relationship's where you can't quite get in a big city.
You have a great weekend.
All right, see you.
Mike is an oncology pharmacist with the Hayward Area Memorial Hospital. For Mike, it's all about the people.
I like to personally deliver meds to the patient. That gives me an opportunity to talk to the patient, especially on their first cycle, what we call, of their chemotherapy.
Did you have any questions at all with your infusion today?
Not right now, no.
They get a lot of information when they go in that doctor's office, and a lot of it, they may have some emotions going, they're getting good news, bad news, that sort of thing. When they come to us, it gives us an opportunity to ask them what they do understand, what they did take away from what the physician may have told them, identify what they need to know.
One of those patients who appreciates that open and honest communication is Barbara Williamson.
Mike's a sweetheart. He brings me my poison every time. He comes in, I say, oh, you got my poison.
Feeling better from
yes.
last week and stuff? I know we're going to be checking your labs today. And
he was always warm, always said hi, you know, would take the time to answer a question. He always asks if you have any questions. I think any time you can deepen a relationship with more facets to it, it becomes a more meaningful relationship on both sides.
There is an increased need for pharmacists in rural areas because of an aging population and the expanding roles that pharmacists face in clinics and hospitals. Two other factors play a major role as well.
There's a disproportionate number of pharmacists and pharmacy students that are going into rural areas. We have about 14% of our graduates end up going into rural areas. The Wisconsin population is about 27% rural. We have a lot of older male pharmacists who are owning independent pharmacies in rural areas. And as time goes on and they get closer to retirement age, there are not pharmacists that are coming out to those environments to buy the pharmacies from them. And those critical access points, those pharmacies then close and never open again.
The University of Wisconsin-Madison School of Pharmacy recognizes these challenges and is building a curriculum to face the changing needs of Wisconsin.
Many of the pharmacists practicing in rural and urban settings come from our school. And so we are uniquely positioned to develop programming using our alums, using the communities that we form to help our students currently train as excellent rural health practitioners. We have over 60 clerkship rotations where students spend 6 weeks as part of a community practicing and being mentored by a rural health pharmacist in rural settings. And that is an invaluable experience for students. So it's taking that combination of community engagement, student engagement, and that actual hands-on experience. That's our recipe for this program to get students out and making a difference.
We'll see you next week.
Being a pharmacist in a rural community can offer advantages for the practitioner, for the patients too. Robert O'Donnell's treatment plan for his rare type of pancreatic cancer requires an imposing medication regimen, several different medications in different doses. For Robert, having a knowledgeable and trusted local pharmacist available is essential.
Hi, Bob. How you doing?
Good.
You're going to pick up prescriptions today?
Yeah.
Okay.
What I need from the pharmacies are continuing drugs for the rest of my life. That's a lot of drugs, and a lot of communication has to happen between me and the pharmacy. Bobbi helps out a lot. I'm really happy that she's here in this system to help me and help the many people daily.
Overall okay?
Yes.
Okay.
After a while, you get to be family. You get to know each other really well. It establishes a relationship that you can trust.
That's where the trust and the confidence and the advice, when you've known somebody that long, even if it's at the pharmacy counter, but over time, you get to know them well enough that when the subjects do come up.
It's a new pain medication today, we're gonna try.
It's pretty easy to dive in quickly because you've already established that trust.
Trust, community, responsibility. It's those things that motivate Bobbi and other pharmacists in small towns across the state to go to work every day and develop strong partnerships with their patients.
I think for most of us, that's why we're in the profession. Those are the days that you go home and say, this was a great day. No matter how busy it was, no matter how much the phone was ringing or anything else, those are the days you get home and think, that one I really made a difference.
There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you later.
You bet.